It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood, a neighborly day for a beauty. Could you be mine? Would you be mine? I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood like you. So let's take a look at this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, "Would you be mine? Would you be neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please? Please, won't you be my neighbor?" Madam Contest Chair, fellow Toastmasters, and guests, neighbors, my singing sounds better in the shower. How many of you guys know that song by a raise of hands? Awesome. For those of you who didn't raise your hands, that song was an introduction to Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood by Mr. Rogers. Also, he would change from his blazer into a sweater and change his shoes every time he entered the show. Why? I have no clue. I did figure out one thing though, guys. Every show, he went to a place called Make Believe. Now, Make Believe, that's where goals, dreams, anything you could think was in Make Believe. So I found out this is the formula to get to Make Believe. So I started to apply the Mr. Rogers formula to everything. I have goals, I have dreams. Anybody here have goals, dreams? Yes. Anybody want to know how to actually accomplish those?
Yeah.
Awesome. So, going through school, I had probability and statistics. I only pulled this out for the hard stuff. And I said, it's my finals, I need to pass. So I said, I'm gonna do it big time. I went to school with my extra sweater, my extra set of shoes, started singing the song all the way to class. By the time I got to the door, changed my shirt, had my shoes, boom, took the final, and guess what? I barely passed. Fractions from failure. Maybe the sweater was different. Maybe I did the song a little wrong. So I said, okay. Luckily, I got married. Beautiful wife, and we're having our first child. So, I don't know about you guys, but I wanted a boy. So I said, boom, I gotta bring out the sweater, and the shoes, and the song. We're going to the sonogram. People look at me wrong. I'm singing the song in the waiting room. We're going to, I remember like it was yesterday. Screen comes up, I'm just waiting for a penis. I sang the song, I had the sweater, it's a girl. That's not right. A year later, we're having our second child. So I'm like, perfect. I worked on my pitch, worked on the sweater, blazer, shoes, sang the song. Doctor said, it's a girl. I'm like, okay. Was Mr. Rogers lying to me? Can I not get to make believe and have my goals and my dreams? What am I doing wrong? I said, I'm gonna try this one more time where I needed it most, work. I wanted a raise, I got two kids now. So I said, all right, I went to work. I didn't care how ugly and stupid I sounded and looked. I went there singing, and I took my extra sweater, took my extra set of shoes. My boss looked at me, laughed, and said, no. I started to feel bad, guys. I started to really, like, I didn't know where to turn. You know, a lot of people go different places when they're feeling helpless. I needed direction, clarity. I went to the one place I knew where to go. YouTube. Got some popcorn and some ginger ale, and I watched every episode of Mr. Rogers. Hours and hours and hours trying to find out what am I missing, what piece of this puzzle, so I can get to make believe. It was like Mr. Rogers came out of the screen and yanked me and said, Quentin, this is what you need to do. And from there, everything changed for me. You guys want to know what he told me?
Yes.
He said, "Quentin, it's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy feeling strong inside. I want to make a snapping It's a good feeling. Very good feeling. Feeling, you know, that I'll be back. I'll have more ideas for you. You'll have things you want to talk about. I will too." That's how he answers his questions. And then he said, "It's the things inside. Your goals, your dreams, they're all yours. You are the answer." And he told me, he said, "Quentin, you need to invest in you. You're the best you in this world. And everything you want and your goals and dreams, as long as you be yourself, you could accomplish them." Then I turned from Quentin Mezitin to Quentin Mezitin, the Mind Investor. And since then, I've won. My next child was a boy. I did it right. No. And everything financially, business, mentally, has increased in all aspects because I took Mr. Rogers' advice and I became myself and I started to invest in me. And ladies and gentlemen, that's all I want to tell you guys from Mr. Rogers, invest in you. Neighbors, that's all for today. Bye-bye.